Hey, I'm such a big crybaby, you know. Whew, I can't help it. Today is my exodus, and I'm up here cleaning out my desk, and it's so difficult for me because I have so many memories, good memories. Even I have memories of struggles, like, whew, you know. So I just happened to be saving personal files off my, had a couple of laptops, and I was looking at this one, and we were asked to share about ourselves, and actually this is one of my videos, but we were asked to share about ourselves, and Raylene, one of my co-workers, videoed it, and I'm just sitting here, just so many memories. And I said, well, Lord, it's probably good that nobody's here. Like, this board became my whole quote board, and I'm so grateful for all the relationships. And of course, nobody's here because of the social distancing, and we're non-essential workers, but I'm like, Lord, it's probably good because this is like one of the most dynamic teams that I've worked with. And I don't know if they think I just say that, but I always enjoy working with people, but this team here, really smart. Really smart people, good people. And so I'm walking across the hall because I was, bringing stuff back, turning in computers and bringing in carts that I stuffed away at home. I was gonna bring back, and then I guess I'd keep one, and then I'd bring another one. And so I was walking through the hallway and bringing stuff back and putting it in the storage room, right? And so I walk past Ingrid's office, and what do I see? Hope. I was able to give my coworkers those hope crosses for Christmas. I'm just really struggling. Like many of you know, I like to hug. I love hugs. And there's nobody to hug right now. Like, the office is empty. And I look like Rudolph. I know, I'm just really struggling. It is an exciting time. But when people have made an impact, when people are like family, I don't see my family and community engagement team like coworkers. I see them like family. Like Ari, she's not here, of course, today, but him and our office together, and he's probably celebrating while I'm crying. But, we harass each other sometimes. I don't think we've just argued, but we take some stabs at each other and jabs here and there, not stabs, jabs. Sometimes I feel like it shouldn't be a stab. But anyway, he did ask me to leave a hope quote, and so I'm about done. My walls are empty. My space is pretty empty, and I walk away. I walk away with a box and a few more items. But this is really hard for me. Like, while I'm excited, part of me is really nervous, like really nervous. And then part of me is really sad because I'm not gonna have the same dynamics with these wonderful people that are like family. Like, we've laughed and cried and we like prayed for each other. We did devotions with each other. We've served together. We've ate together. We've danced together. Well, I think I did more of the dancing and they videoed and made fun. I think why it's so hard is because I struggled really bad. Like, my first year and a half, I've only been in this department 2 years, but my first year and a half was very emotional years for me. Like, even up until my brother's death, it's been an emotional time. And I leaned on them more than they know. And I tell them I love them, but I don't think they understand. All the schools, you know, all the nice emails and calls. I really take those things to heart. I promise you I'm gonna celebrate like I've been celebrating, but this is like my emotions are just, y'all know I'm over the top when it comes down to emotions, so I think I have about 30 more minutes and I'm gonna wrap up. This is my exodus. I don't think it's just my exodus from DISD. I think it's my exodus from the workplace. Like, until I transition, I feel that I'm going to be free and flexible to operate in my God-created identity, like with no constraints, like full pledge, whatever I feel is best and how God leads me. So just full reign, R-E-I-G-N, reign, to operate at my best capacity. So, this is it. Matter of fact, I'm gonna tell you how the hope quote started, cause I'm gonna do that with you. Most of the time, the hope quotes were speaking to my heart, and it was me building my faith, right? And so I would sit here at this board, or whatever board I had at the time. Sometimes I would bounce up out of my seat and it would just come to me and I'd write it down. And sometimes it was hard, like it is now when my heart is heavy. So, I'm gonna date it. It's April 8th. 2020. I'm gonna put a quote. I try to think about how I feel. And now it's like excited and sad, so I don't know what kind of quote's gonna come out of today. Hope gives you a range of emotions. That's the quote for today that comes to heart. There we go. Hope gives you a range of emotions. So Ulrich didn't get with the, my office mate didn't get with the hope quotes at first. And I'm sure my eyes are black from my eyeliner running. But he eventually he started helping me or kind of thinking things through. And then I think he started maybe looking at them, you know. And so he did ask me to leave one on his board. So I am a clown too. You know why? I cry and I'm very serious. And sometimes I'm known as the warden and preacher. And I've got so many, I have like multiple personalities. Really, I do. And so that's just who I am. That's how God created me. I don't apologize for that. That's who I am. And so now I'm thinking like, you know what? I'm going to give him a good quote, all right. He wanted me to write it on his board. And so he said, of course, he gives me specific instructions, right? And so I'm going to leave him one. Let's see how creative I can be. I'm going to date it April 8th, 2020. Ulrich, this is for you if he ever watches my videos. So here we go. His quote is, hope never quits. That's what I feel for him today. Hope never quits. Hope never quits. So that's his quote. So, hey, thanks for thanks for allowing me to be myself. And I do feel better since I did the hope quote. So that's kind of what happened. So I started doing one, and then next thing I know, I do another one, and then I do another one. And I think I've been doing these hope quotes now for, I know, a good 2 years. So guess what? There's a hope quote book coming. And guess who needs finances in this season of faith? So get ready. A hope quote book is coming, and I'm asking for your support now. So God bless you. It's coming. Stay tuned. My exodus. And guess what? My exodus into what my superior said, my metamorphism. I think that's how you say that word. Because I was like, I'm glad you left. I was 1 minute away from just breaking down. And her and I have such a bond because she was really there for me when my brother passed. Like, I don't think she really understands. Like, when I got those calls, she came running outside and, like, one of the last conversations with my brother, like, she was there. Like, when I say she was there, she was there. Shout out to Liliana Valadez, excuse me, Dr. Liliana Valadez. Shout out to her. She's been a great superior, and I know I may get in trouble for shouting out different people today, but like Tony Neal, she was really there for me. Like, when I first started in this department, I couldn't even hardly think straight. I was going through so many emotional turmoils and was going through grief. God has blessed me with some really good managers, and I remember Tony Neal. Like, I'd go into her office and talk to her, and whoo, she would literally, like, I think she was like a counselor to me and a boss, a friend, coach. Like, I remember her dialing the phone up and saying, okay, your parents need what? Okay, let's call the number. I mean, you know, she down to business. Like, let's do this. And she actually helped me through that in, like, Virginia. Like, I know I'm gonna get in trouble for calling these names, but like, people, this team, like Irish would pray and Marlene would be there and help me ask. Like, I'd ask questions after 4:30 p.m. You know, we were like the late crew, and Ray Lynn would try to support me, and then she'd go missing out of the office. Next thing I know, she's went and got Irish, come pray. And Ray Lynn was always there, my office mate, to put up with my crazy stuff and video me and laugh and cry. Like, this is family, y'all. And Stephanie, you know, she'd come right on along, and just so many, like, I can't name everybody, but oh my God, I basically named the CST team because they're the ones I was closest to. But oh man, I gotta go. Talk to y'all later.